In today's session, we will learn fundamental of data analytics. Since it is a series for the beginners, we will not use any complex tools or code, but we will use only Excel. We will divide the entire video in four parts to understand four critical steps to start data analytics in Excel. First, data transformation. The second, data understanding with descriptive statistics. Third, data analysis as per the questions asked. And fourth, storytelling through visualizations and reporting. If you're watching this far, that means you're serious about learning fundamentals of data analysis. So, to get regular update on tricks and tips of data analytics using Excel, please subscribe to Data Bicep. Do not forget to like this video to send your regards to the whole of analyst community. Let's go to the Excel. The Excel link is given below so that you can download it for practicing. First step of any data analysis is to understand the question properly. A global toy company is selling its toys across different markets. Is it multiple SKUs? Say bus, trains, cars? And we have to analyze its sales performance across different geographies. And for that, we were given 3 years of sales data, and that includes SKUs, sales date, sales volume, sales amount, various customer informations, and then few more. Data transformation is a process in which you transform the data from a format given to you to a format that you need for analysis. You can do data transformation using Power Query. We already have a video. You can click the link above for that video. But today, we will do using classical Excel techniques. The first step of any analysis is to check the data from two point of views. The first question you should ask that whether we have the right data set of doing the analysis. And for that, first you need to check if we have bare minimum data point that you need for the analysis. Since we need to analyze the sales, we need to have few critical information available. The order informations, and we say that we have the basic order information, the sales informations, the product lines, and where the product is shipped to. That means who is the customer. So it seems we have the basic data that we need, though the quality may not be the right, but we can start with this data. The next most important question is the data in usable format? This is more of a forensic analysis, which is more of an art than science, but let's try to take the most common approach. The first step is to convert it into an Excel table. And for that, you select this whole piece and click Ctrl T. Let me change the color of the header. Let's see, automatically black so that we can all read it. Okay. So typically there could be various different kind of data quality issues that prohibits us from using the set. And most common are, the first is not clean. The second could be the data type error. Third could be duplicate, blank or empty data, and so on. So let's try to find this one by one. We can clearly see that customer name is not clean because it has multiple unpredictable spaces, and we will run into issues if we later try to group by using customer name as a column. So let's first trim it both the ends and put everything in uppercase so that we have a uniform value across the column. For that, insert one more column called trim and uppercase function for customer name. And here you are. Let's rename the column as customer name clean, and we will use this column for further calculations. The next issue we will address is data type error. And it is one of the most common error. That means in the place of text, you get decimal. In the place of decimal, you get date, and so on and on. It's something that needs to be addressed. Otherwise, the calculations downstream will be erroneous. One example is price here. Ideally, price has to be a decimal number, but we see few text here. So we have to get rid of those rows which has text, because we cannot calculate numbers using text. So what we will do, let's select the text rows. First, unselect all, select only the text rows, and we have filtered all the text rows. So now select all, and we will delete these rows. Though it solves the problem of data type error, but it introduces another problem. that's duplicate blank rows, and we have to solve that in our next step. Sometimes we see not only blank rows but duplicate rows as well. This creates a lot of problem because if there are duplicate values, you tend to double count that. We will deal with both the issues at once. So let's do one thing. Go to the data, select remove duplicates, and it takes the whole of it and it removes duplicates value. See, the 579 duplicate values found. You just click OK and all the blank and duplicate rows are vanished. Now we have relatively clean data. Sometime we may need more data than what's given to us, and it's called data enrichment. Let's take an example that we have many city names where the product was shipped, but our country is completely messed up. But if we have to do an analysis based on the country, we just cannot do that. So there are various ways we can do the enrichment. One, we can look at each of the city and go to Google and try to find out which country it is, or we can use a geography data type. And geography data type is an extremely important data type that any analyst can use. And we have a video for that. If you want, you can go and check the link. But to do that, the first thing what you have to do, you have to convert the city into a geography data type. You just select the city column, go to the data, click the data types, and convert that into geography. And you see this little small maps, and that means it got converted into a geography. So there will be few errors. It's not exactly error. It's not able to understand that when we talk about this North Sydney, which country it belongs. So we say North Sydney is in Australia. Let's delete the entire piece here. And we will derive the country name from the city name. Is equal to select, put a dot, and write country and region name. And that fetches all the country names of respective cities. Now you have enriched data set, which not only has city, but it has the country name as well. So what all we did, the first thing, we cleaned the data. Second thing, we looked at the data type error and we control that. Third thing, we looked at the duplicate or blank data and we remove that data for the ease of calculation. And the final step is that we enrich the data with more information which was perennially not there, but we need for calculations. Now, since we have a complete data set using which we can do analysis, let's go to the next step to understand overall data distribution.
Continue to part 2 for data understanding. Please like, share, subscribe Data Bicep.